event?
I thought it was beautiful. I was saying to her that it's really important to have a space where everybody has the same intention and everybody's here for the same thing, so you can feed off that energy and go home with it. So yeah.
I know I'm supposed to be here because I was actually on Eventbrite looking at events only on Monday.
Oh, wow.
And typed in self-love and this came up. So I know that I'm supposed to be here, like a divine developer. I'm supposed to be here today.
I think I'm my biggest fan. I know I'm my biggest critic, I'm already aware of that, but I think I'm my biggest fan. I think it's okay to be my biggest fan. And I asked my Twitter followers, do you agree? And most of them said yeah, and like right on or whatever, but there were a few who were like, no, it's not, you can't be a biggest fan. You have to have somebody else to pick you up. But you're the only person that is inside your brain. You go to sleep by yourself, you might have someone there next to you, but they're not in your head. You have lived your whole life, you're the star of your own movie. Literally, when I walk out of here today, I don't exist anymore to you guys, because this is your life, it's your own universe. So why is everyone else so important? It's so easy to get caught up with what other people are doing, like what hair someone has, what job they have, how do they get it, why are they doing that, why does this happen to them, why not me? But they're not worrying about you, number one. And secondly, if you took all of the energy, because I used to be like that as well, like when I first started presenting and blogging and stuff, I used to look at people and think, oh, she got that job, I would be better at that job. Or why did this brand work with her and not work with me? Or, you know, just like, no, it's not hating, but it's just, it's self-depreciative. And what you have to understand is that the energy that you put in to disliking yourself and not looking after yourself, and also the way that just, it just emanates from you and it makes you dislike other people and be jealous of other people. If you just flip that and use that energy for something good or to tell yourself good things, your life can actually flip around.
Within. Everything starts from within. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to ask a request for some people in the audience. Would somebody like to come and share what they've written? And I ask this because stepping into your fears is the first way of getting over them. Doing things that you're scared of is how you grow. And this is a beautiful, ooh, go ahead, give me a round of applause. Yeah.
I am proud of you because you've stuck to drinking smoothies for the better part of a year and you're still going. I'm proud of you because in your own way, as scared as and as self-conscious and vulnerable as you might feel, you still put yourself out there most days. Still express and share yourself. Ebele, you are unique simply because there is no one like you and there will never be. I am really fearful of a lot of things, but when times get hard, remember that you are never alone. The universe sees you, angels do too, and other forces that are there for you and who. That are there for you and who you truly are. They see you. I will always love you because I have loved you from the beginning. I have loved you from the beginning. It's my default setting, my only setting. I see you.
Today's event was really fun and inspiring and great set of people in a great location that could talk about how to love yourself.
myself in her. And with a strange numbers, we just became friends. It wasn't like a fan singer kind of relationship, so we were just mates. And like she come down to London with like shopping together. She's a cool, a very, very cool girl. And she was going for a little friendship, it sounds bad for excuse my language, but you know, we're both struggling with accepting certain parts of ourselves, feeling comfortable with ourselves. You know, we're all looking both for but young, like, you know, this fucking internet, in this whole internet world, that's where we first met. And it's just all fake. And she taught me, I think that's the thing to, you know, I don't think she ever realised how much she actually inspired me. She's a very inspiring girl. And she was the sort of person that, I remember a clear change in her where she was like, I'm gonna change this, do this, like, I'm working towards it. And she just did it. She just got up one day and was just like, boom. Put everything that she thought about into practice. And then, yeah, became really inspired to go on to help other people and help empower other people. So that's what we all have to carry forward now, like, trust me, because her energy, I always feel it with me. We just got to keep that going. Like, love yourselves and love other people, make other people feel good around you. Because that's ultimately what we want to feel good.
Emma would tell us to make the most of every minute of our lives, because you don't know how much time you have. She would tell us to fight your fears and do the things you want to do, even if they scare you. You never know how much time you have. Don't leave until tomorrow what you can do today. She would tell you to aim high in every aspect of your life. Work for the things you want and don't ever give up. Be proud of the things you've already achieved and use them as the building blocks for greater things. Care for those around you and let them look after you when you need it. Don't isolate yourself. Emma would tell you that you are beautiful and to never worry about the way you look or how much you weigh. Always remember, looks won't get you through life, and if it does, it won't last forever. Are your looks going to help you when you can't pay your bills and you're sitting in the dark? Will it help you when you become ill or something bad happens? Will your looks get you through the tough times and help make a difference in the world? Most likely not.
What are you going to do to start loving yourself? What activities are you going to take up?
Start doing a sport to keep my mind healthy, and a sport that I enjoy, so it's something I enjoy rather than a chore. Okay.
Round of applause for that.
Congratulate yourself when you do something you're proud of.
Lovely. What are we going to start doing?
Doing something each month, at least once, that's for you. So whether it's going to the park and sitting in the sun, booking a spa day, going to see friends, eating a cake that you wouldn't normally eat, to just do something that you want to do and enjoy, and just not worrying about anything else, just enjoying you.
I thought it was really good because I feel like we need this a lot more. We need a lot more events where people are invited to talk about things that they don't really talk about, or things that scare them, or being more vulnerable, because it makes you realise that everyone is the same. So I think it was really good. Enjoyed it.
Doing your hair in a difficult way. Going to a charity shop and buying a dress. You know what I mean? These things don't cost a lot. Walking in the park. Writing a love letter to yourself. Listening to some happy music and dancing. Like nobody, these things don't cost a penny, right? And if you do these things daily, 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 they all become a big thing. And it's about making a commitment, because we have so many negative kind of messages coming at us daily through the media, through TV, through radio, through music. And if you don't have that protective barrier around you, you can get sucked in. Like Yinka said, you can get sucked into the Instagram life or the Snapchat, oh my God, that person's got that person's got a boyfriend, he's got, well, I'll talk about myself here, that person's got a husband, I have a blah, blah, blah. But it's not about that. Like, everybody's on their own journey. And what's for you will never pass you by. What's for you will that pass you by is coming. But it can only enter the space when you're vibrating at the same level as it. If you're not on the level of it, it's not coming in, I'm telling you. So if you want this big house, but you're always talking about you're broke, the house ain't coming, mate. The house ain't coming. It ain't coming. Right? You're talking about, oh, I want a boyfriend, but you look at yourself and say, I'm ugly every single day. How can you expect someone to love you when you're feeling ugly? Love yourself first. It all starts with you, literally.
On and on.